And all the way close up to the game.
Oh, yeah, con lo visto la week, cosa
ya. Ajá. No me acordaba hasta ahorita que le dije a la Bella, dice nada, si quieres a la week.
Pero vamos a ver.
You can't see the edge of that shit.
That's good.
You can't see the edge, you know, pretty close. Fix the edge.
その末端は低予算で小型の腕程なく子供殺傷能力を誇り技術さえ確立してしまえば短期間での大量生産が可能なことと学園の得意な姿からミニチュアローズ金座のバラと呼ばれ独裁小国家に好まれた。 esto con la juventud de Machinal. Yo que no tengo puedo ver a Daneta como un chinito. Son la una, marca con la papa de ti y quiero.
My shoe is ready, bro.
What?
Fuck, I haven't had enough, bro. No, don't tell me that. That's all bad, bro.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
What's up, there, bro? Fuck, bro, I don't have enough to fucking... That's all bad. Cowboys contra los Bengals, ¿eh?
Están jugando en CBS. Están viendo contra los Cardenales. Están ganando los Raiders. 23-7. ¿Los Cowboys están jugando?
Los Broncos son basura. Esos ya los tiraron afuera. A ver,
los Los Packers.
¿Quiénes son por ellos?
Los Packers y los Chicago Bears.
Wait, everything's capitalized on it, isn't it? Ese salió de la universidad de la LSU, ¿no?
Thank you.
Thanks, bro. That's all bad. fuck you guys, bro. You have been great. You're the bitch, bro.
The only time I've been shopping is just everyone on request food. So your camera can see in the dark with night sight. Fix your photos with magic erasers. Photoshop all skin tones accurately with photo touch. And last up to 72 hours of extreme battery saving. It's only the engine. Google Pixel 6. Search for the computer hours and Google Pixel 6 later with all of our applications.
Thank you.
right through the glass, bro. Hicieron los
vengadores.
20 a 17, ¿no? Recibieron dos intervenciones.
Estoy jugando, pero
estaba
mirando
también
la
ciudad. Mira. Está sorprendido el 0-0 de los Cowboys. Ajá, porque los vengadores podían ganarlo, pero el patrón lo. No lo metió en el medio y ganaron los. Ya los Lakers. El Charlie Curry. Tienen unos 6 segundos.
¿Unos 6 segundos?
16 and a half. They have on flag. Ma Maria.
But if players outside the locker, you're not the person shouting word, and you don't have to do that as a defensive back. So what's the timing of that play? The flat come early while Kyler Murray is still inside the pocket, or when he was scrambling, based on the timing of the flat, it means that Murray is still in the pocket. And then the first goal from the 3-yard line.
Murray, there you go, there you go. Oh, touchdown!
I mean, look at Rock Cassin with that hand placement. I mean, he couldn't put his hand in a better place, but there is no doubt that, you know, one of the favorite 3 million receivers here in the last decade of football. you got a lot of good chances.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, that's kind of who he is and what he does.
Because
I'm here, where can we go to overtime? I think you've got to make, you've got to have some sort of pressure here. You think you're going to
this?
And there is a flag. Wow. Yeah, that's...
Wow.
How do you let that happen? Brutal. That's a brutal, brutal play for Cardinals. But I think, Greg... Down here, inside the 5, inside the 10,
you've
seen Murray, when he has time, he's been able to dance around and really hurt this defense with his legs. And so, that hasn't worked for you. You haven't been able to kick out of the front of
Arizona.
So, you really got to think about bringing some pressure, and that means if you do, the defensive backs have to be able to hold up in coverage. Now, this looks like a coverage defense. It's gotta be
a good
That leg, we're beating Houston 16-8. Denver.
Oh, yeah?
Denver versus Houston, we're beating them 16-8.
Oh, I feel like the Patriots lose up. They're getting trashed from
the quarterback. They don't let one train.
And just drops it in.
You caught that shit good. Look at that shit.
You see him gesturing to his left, and A.J. Green is the only one who was going right to left. I mean, that's just unbelievable. I think that was a dreamer who was in underneath coverage. Well, he's about half an inch from getting his hand up and knocking down that net. Yeah, it's this angle I was looking at here in the studio too, Greg, and watching the right arm of the receiver as that ball comes down. It appears to me in this one little opening as if the right hand is off at the ball in that angle. Now he's got to finish this and survive the ground. This is a great look here, but he kind of turns right at that point. So you have nothing right there that can tell you you can overturn it. So I'm sure what they're doing is looking at every possible angle they can before they go to overtime here, fellas. So, Gene, question, in your estimation, is there enough there that would warrant, you know, overturning this, which would be a huge call? Not at this point, Adam, and I think that's what they're actually doing in New York, is you'll go through every possible angle. Nothing that I've seen now tells me that there's been indisputable evidence to overturn. So they'll continue to do what we call empty the bucket, and that is take as long as they need to see every possible angle available. But there is a little bit of movement that does add a little gray area element. Am I correct? Most definitely, yes. Yes, there definitely is. And I, again, was looking at the right hand because it initially appeared to be under the football, which gives you a little more confidence that he has it secure. But then at the last minute there, seconds or so, that right hand kind of comes and is on top. The left is underneath as he starts to turn, and that's the piece that they're, I'm sure, continuously looking at right now to see if there's anything that comes out where they can overturn. The official's in great position. He sees it closer than all of us, with no one between him. And that's why this ruling of the catch is so important as this process takes place. Gene, thank you. The decision has been made. Here we go.
After a year, the rule will field stands as tall as the catch or 2.5 from Davis.
Damn, man, that's it.
So the diving catch by A.J. Green means that we head to OT. So 23-23, we take the point. Start overtime.
It's the same thing. I knew that that person was high school, so I'll admit it. I'm going to pass on God. You do not need to get that person. The state council for five pounds simply let the judge score this one. That's pretty good.
For real?
You got it for the jazz band. Who is that guy? Jazz. Call it quick to get a quote today. Might be good neighbor. Stay kind of fun. Welcome back, everyone. We're going to kick off of the Bears and the Green Bay Packers. And it's the North rivalry extraordinaire. It's going to be some time on NBC.
So here we go. Power time. Dino Benjamin. Will not get the long distance back. And the touchback. Put the back to the 25-yard line. And on the weekend, good.
For Kyler Murray and this Cardinals offense to get back in this game, and here we go, overtime.
The Cardinals did not play an overtime game at all last season. The Raiders were 4-0 in OT in 2021.
Greg, I think it's a big advantage for the Cardinals to win the coin toss because the Raiders have been on, their defense has been on the field 51 plays in the second half. And they're just coming off an 18-play drive. So they have got to be winded up front, and that's to the Cardinals' advantage. Thank you. Brought up by Devon Diablo.
Well, you have two entirely different football games, first half and second half for Cardinals. Carter Raiders should just 3 second half points.
Yeah, it's incredible.
Well, it's shot complete and out of bounds. The catch is made by Steven Anderson. University of California.
Look at that, it's almost a mirror image. 51 plays in the second half. I mean, that is a lot of plays. And especially, again, like, going up against a quarterback like Connor Murray, or you've got to chase him around and you've got to try to get him out of the ground. That is a lot. Second and eight. Oh, we're in the middle, and that's going to come across midfield. Coach, your 45-yard line is Marquise Brown. Marquise Brown looked when he was coming out of his break. And he looks like he just shot right out of that break and it was drive. He didn't have to slow up one half of a step. Ball was perfectly in stride. He's able to catch it.
Yeah,
and
keep going.
It's a good thing that
Hawks
was so close behind him, because that's what those Saints can get for a touchdown.
And the Broncos are beating the Texans.
Down, Arizona.
And the Patriots are smacking the Raiders.
Están chingados a los Houston, Eva. Están chingados a los Houston.
¿Quién?
Los Broncos.
Y los otros, los Steelers, van a
26 a 9, yo creo.
Mira, ahí dice abajo. Mira, los Buccaneros están ganando.
26
o 16. Los Carolinas están ganando.
Washington.
Pero San Francisco está 27 a 7 en
Colombia.
Los Rams están perdiendo. Mira, ahí están los Broncos, están ganando a los Houston. Mira,
los Patriotas. ¿Los Patriotas
por qué huelan? A los Steelers los están ganando.
Oh,
los Raiders.
The Cardinals have everything they needed. Marquise Brown wide open on the sideline. And Harmon just comes his side of the hash mark and gets that ball out to set up Derek Carr on the 36-yard line.
Inside,
and then he comes in from behind. Goes
dives right for the football. Now he chances to get it there. Unbelievable that Morrow. Yeah, he's got 5-5-2 Cardinals to get that football. But what a game. Terrible finish to go on at the bottom of those piles. Yes. I know you like horror movies. All the opportunities, all the chances that both defenses have had. Because it's not on the same page as with Devontae Adams and Jalen Thompson, who had three interceptions last year. Has a chance to be a hero. Now, it would have been an incredible interception, but not a good throw by Derek Carr.
Entonces, ¿pero qué dices? ¿Qué estás diciendo?
¿Para quién? ¿Fue de ellos o no? En el defense, ¿cómo? 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 ¿Cómo?
Raiders fall to 0-2. The final score, 29-23 Arizona. Tonight on CBS afternoon, 60 minutes, Alabama will get another and an equalizer. The Admiral Trevon, AJ Rock, Gene Starter, our entire crew, Greg Nicholson, so long from Las Vegas. You can watch it in the NFL on CBS.
Ya no van a, ya no están mirando otros equipos, ¿no? A ver.
This week at CBS Sports Center with Chanel Next. Introducing Del Taco's new epic tour. Three hot and savory Mexican-style sandwiches on a big, freshly toasted 7-inch roll. Hot crispy chicken with hot snake guacamole. Chicken BLT or carne asada with queso. New epic tours. Bigger, tastier, epicer. Say hello to Del Taco veterans. And say hello to free Del Taco delivery in the app every weekend in September. Some people like to talk in the mic. We prefer drive. NBA. A new era of Indian performance. You go by that. Veteran. Team. God. Dance styles and cheerleading. So adding a student title, I feel overwhelming. What if the school could be there for all of you? Career, family, finances, and mental health. Well, the team. National University. Supporting the whole youth.
Why?
Our Sports Center Sunday. I'm Jim Gray, joined by former USC NFL star Jeff Favors and ESPN's Alan Silver. We just saw right here on CBS 2 Arizona 29
Commanders 23. It's absolutely dope. You played in some overtime games, so you know the pressure that you're under.
Yeah, by the year you played the Bengals 11 in overtime, and I know those overtime games come down to taking care of your opportunities that you get. They dropped the pass of Hollywood down on fourth down, and forced the fumble that the Raiders recovered, and then ultimately, 10 plays later, forced another one and coming for a touchdown, and that's the only reason they won, is they're taking care of those opportunities.
And I've been doing them again, all you can see is
right here. They're
going
to
be so many backs and traps and forwards. It looked like the Raiders had the game in control of the entire game, but
The Rams are back at SoFi Stadium today to host the Atlanta Falcons. The Rams are back at SoFi Stadium today to host the Atlanta Falcons. The Rams are 28-18 against the Falcons. The Rams went to that area and had 7-0 in the second quarter. Here's Darrell Henderson. First touchdown of the year. Rams lead it 14-0. Atlanta looking to start before halftime, down 14-3. DeMarcus Murray is passed down to the hands of Cordell Patterson and right into Kobe Gant. The rookie takes his first quarter reception back 51 yards for the score. The Rams offense takes advantage. Matthew Stafford picks up with his favorite target in Cooper Cup. Double touchdown. The Rams lead at halftime by a score 21-3. More of the same in the third quarter now. Stafford swings it out to the winning Super Bowl MVP in fact. He makes a man-eyes and scores for the second time today. Rams in control now 28-3. Meanwhile, Drake Lambert making his return to Los Angeles make it really count. And Lambert's next drive, Mario Lillard, connects with his first-round draft choice out of USC. That's Lambert's first career touchdown, and he's happy about that. That sparks an Atlanta comeback. Now down 31-17 in the fourth quarter. They force the Rams punt, and they block it. Lorenzo Carter picks it up, got a streak, and the score. They add the two-point conversion to make it 31-25. Right? That's a little fun. Special teams right there. Obviously, this is one of the big keys of the game.
How's that funny?
An opportunity to win. That's what New Year's Day is. Now the Rams are trying to put the game away from 4-4. Second goes over a minute to go. But Kevin Hart is going to lose.
But
the Falcons still had one final chance in the final seconds. Now Ray tries to buy some time.
Change the title of it.
But he gets hit and loses the ball. Rams hanging on to win it. Twitter finds here 31-27. Fundamentals. Now, both of you gentlemen saw several late mistakes for the Rams and almost cost them this one.
Yeah, they're trying to get cute late, right? They were dominating the game. They started passing it. I felt like they should have ran the ball a little more. They had a bunch of success early running the ball. Matthew Stafford, like that gunslinger mentality, he threw the ball away a few times and then those jump home. But as we said, the details matter.
And when you talk about, you know, the details matter, you know, everybody wants to play well and everybody wants to win, but it's really amazing how when everybody's yelling and screaming in the stands, the calmest people in the stadium are the tickets
on the field. I tell you what, you know, you go frustrated, obviously, when the Falcons made this one a game, but you're right, Jim. Ultimately, at the end, the players came through, Jalen Ramsey came through.
Yeah, and Sam, you remember your first career sack and interceptions as well for Kobe Hunter, who recovered both of them.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Thank you.
Chevy
Silverado.
It's got the power you want. And the capability you need to do the job. So you can get to the important work. Find new moments, find new roads. The Silverado with a 2.7-liter turbo engine travels over 400 miles and a full tank of gas. Drops an outdated Texans and get $1,000 accessory allowance for the new Chevy truck with accessories.
Find new roads at your Southern California Chevy dealers.
And welcome back, everybody. The Pittsburgh Steelers at home taking on the Patriots, tied at 3 in the second quarter. Mahomes hits a Nelson Aguilar for, and he makes a spectacular grab on his list of 44-yard touchdown to go up 10-3. And what a catch here by him.
It looks like USC is going to play this week. Yeah. Yeah. The Bucks get on the board now on top 13-3. Jameis Winston throws his third interception of the fourth quarter. Mike Edwards goes back 67 yards for the score.
That's the third.
The Texans now lead the Cowboys and the Bengals are beat it off for their first win of the season. Let's start their straight to the fourth quarter. Just under 4 minutes to go. Bengals down 17-9. To where? Goes out and finds that T. Higgins. Play of the day, sponsored by Malango Casino Resort and Spa. Williams, a new Chevy is the smart way to hit the open road. The smart way to road trip and see new adventures. Go a little farther in a new Chevy. Find your get up and go on new roads. Well qualified buyers can get 1.9% finance or get $1,200 cash allowance on all 2022 Equinox models. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
Inflation. Everything you enjoy with Rivieras are this time. For years, I've been telling you how Riviera Naples has ranked the thousands of the world's finest barbecues at wholesale prices. Behind me is our massive Fabergé house. What else is massive? Call today to get a massive 20% discount off all fabrics on any. any real estate project holiday. Your credits are backed by Thanksgiving guaranteed. Just call 800-555-7.
It sure is convenient to have a handy neighbor. At NextGen Air Heating and Plumbing, we learned thousands of five-star reviews that were just that. Our expert technicians will start by ensuring your family is breathing clean air and drinking clean water. With our air-run air and water filtration solutions to fit any budget. And right now, you can get a full AC heating system safety inspection and tune-up for only $88.
Oh, hell no, boy. Ain't no stress, boss. Let me tune up.
They needed it. They needed that from really good.
Yeah, this was a comeback game for Jalen. We had a tough first week, but he came back and was flying all around the field this week. A lot of the first tackles and that here at the end by six. The Bills, unfortunately, was in a position for the offense to go away a couple of extra possessions from the offense, wherever I was about to grab it. And the Rams were anxious to get back on the field. So if they were anxious, you know, unfortunately, as four quarters got played, even if two quarters were good, they got bad. This is a Super Bowl chance. They're expecting more from Stafford. Cooper Kupp with that. Obviously, the fumble, the special teams got to be better. Walk away with a W, but hopefully they progress better as the season moves on.
And they learned a lot, that is for sure. All right, for more on today's victory, what do you say we check in with our Jake Ryan now at a SoFi Stadium? Jake?
Hey there, Jim. A lot of unnecessary drama in this one. And I'm joined by Rams radio commentator and broadcaster J.B. Long. And J.B., even Sean McVay said he needed an adult beverage after this one. What did you see in that crazy fourth quarter?
Well, hopefully he's buying it. You and me, Jeff. It's good to see him. Good to catch up with you. Look, at the end of that game, up 3 touchdowns, you probably grade that as an A-minus victory, one the Rams feel really good about. Having seen how the fourth quarter played out, maybe knock it down to a B-minus or a C-plus, but it sure beats the alternative in the end. I think that's the most important thing. Falling to 0-2 from up 25 points would have been really tough to stop.
Yeah, no kidding. And also, when you consider the fact that, you know, this is a Falcons team that they definitely should have handled, definitely should have beaten. So one of the positives that I wanted to touch on with you is the Rams get the
Bring them, Chaparro. Packies and fries, bro. Go get them. Go get them for real. I got the fries.
¿Eh? ¿Nos vas a colgar?
He won my fans 2.5 years ago. What the nation was locked to its core. On the third round, he's got a gem. And seven others were killed in a tragic helicopter crash. As part of the new documentary series on the moon, Legacy, the true story of the LA Lakers, members of the team were talking about Faithful Bay. Laker owner Jeannie Best spoke with me about how the community came together and how the players turned their experience into a championship winning team. Legends, sponsored by CarlJacob.com.
Breaking news from the NBA superstar Kobe Bryant.
Why isn't nobody helping me, bro? What the fuck? Where the fuck is my team at, dude? Hell, man. Fucking hate these kids, bro. Oh my god, dude. Get the fuck off my sack. Damn, dude. Fuck you. Fuck you.
The Lakers mean to Los Angeles is more than just a basketball team. It is how we connect and who we are and what we stand for in terms of giving it our all. Maybe you don't win every time, but you're going to commit to being the best that you can be and leave it out.
I'm only gonna fucking do damage, bro. Like, what the fuck, dude?
All right, my friends, here we come. We're gonna wrap things up with the best in fashion from Ron and NFL and week number two on Sunday's Best.
Thank you, guys. Oh, Jesus. Came looking for me, dog.
I'm sitting in a park bar and break 18-wheeler girl. My body was super tense, didn't know where to turn, and I looked up and I saw Jason Ryan posted about it, so I was excited with the results. I suggest anyone else looking for an accident attorney to Jason Ryan. Accident attorney, you see?
A recovery going on. One car, one horn.
Hey, you my dad. Look, dog, you got the clean it. Accident. What is this?
This is a
total basic. It's you look like puss. Oh my god, dog. I fucking hate these fools, dog. All right, bro. All right, bro. All right. Oh, bitch. Oh, bitch. Stop it,
says dueño de GTA.
They're calling you. They're calling you.
Me? What the fuck calling you for? Bro, how did you keep getting me, bro? I'm fucking running. What the fuck?
Oh,
God.
To Major League Baseball, the Angels took two runners to go down in the first inning. Luis Rengifo is at the plate. He sends this into left field with his 14th home run decision. And the Angels lead by a score of 1-0. Now tied at 1. went on. So he beat her again. She's at it again. This time he goes to deep center field. His 15th home run of the year. Two home runs for him on the day. And the Angels have gone Randolph score of 5-1. Okay, time now for week two of Sunday's best. It's actually a fun for a week. This week featuring some sharp-dressed quarterbacks and a few of the best from the Los Angeles Rams. How about this, John? As we talk about this and look at this, let's just talk about the quarterbacks and look at the attire coming and going to the game.
You know, nice and clean. This is a comfort food. This is our favorite.
But there's always those that like to look cool.
Well, Burrow looks cool. Unfortunately, his team isn't very cool right now. They're not looking good, but he looks good.
And of course, here.
You see, Aaron Donald with some organic ostrich. He's good enough for that. That's nice right there.
Yeah, I guess so. He can afford to wear anything he wants.
Yeah, as you said, man. Yeah, you have a Super Bowl dress up on. That's the new T-shirt right there.
Mm-hmm. And it's really kind of amazing how guys go to games, and initially it was always just a certain time and they're very corporate, but now it's almost like anything goes.
Hey, it's fashion. The NBA, they got cameramen just waiting to see the NFL too. That's a part of the game though.
And when you think about it, my friends, that's going to do it for this edition of Sports Central Sunday. And so, I'm Jim Gillison, and I thank so much for watching. And we'll see you next week. Welcome to the
studio. See you.
Okay.
You're
recording. My
client's
private conversation.
Just a little bit of joke.
It's
not a... This is a German
in July, we uncover A-list celebrities violating
the restrictions.
I think following your story can open a lot of eyes. See what we found some of those same celebrities doing now. When it comes to fighting childhood cancer, we're thinking about you. It's your journey. But take it. The makers of Brownwood have set aside $4.5 billion for victims of non-Hodgkin's lymphoma.
If you or a friend get diagnosed with non-Hodgkin's lymphoma after using Rambler, call right now. One phone call is all it takes to get started.
Call us right now. You may be entitled to substantial compensation. Call right now and find out in less than 2 minutes if you may qualify.
Call
1-800-866-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6-6
to keep your head meaning all from fully licensed tickets. Because the only thing that matters more to us than your comfort is your safety. Your next friend, your eating and fun.
What is another one you can kiss in the
Wake up with CBS 2 News this morning, 4:30 to 7 a.m.
Final preparations.
Yes.
Turn to the Elizabeth II's state funeral. World leaders gather in London for the royal goodbye. Today, President Biden paying his respects.
Your hearts go out to world food.
Outside, time runs out for the public. Still, healing in the cold. We'll get the latest from North Carolina and
here outside Buckingham Palace right now.
Into his tire.
Here in Westminster, on the eve of the Queen's state funeral, British police are preparing for an unprecedented day, a public mourning.
Also, it is a new Hummus, Puerto Rico, with extra green and flooding. Plus, atrocities revealed. after Russia's retreat.
This is the CBS Weekend News from New York with Jerika Duncan.
Good evening, I'm Lydia Luciano in New York. Jerika is off. We're following two major stories tonight. The entire island archipelago of Puerto Rico is without electricity after being hit by Hurricane Fiona. The damage is devastating. We'll have much more in a moment. But we begin with world leaders gathering in London for the state funeral of Queen Elizabeth II. Today, President Biden and First Lady Jill Biden visited Westminster Hall, where the former monarch is lying in state. Later, they signed a book of condolences.
Our hearts go out to you, and you were fortunate to have had her for 70 years. We all were. The world's better for her.
CBS's MTS Howard in London tonight and on to South.
Lilia, good evening. Well, the final touches are being put on the Queen's state funeral as Great Britain and the world continue to mourn the late monarch. At the stroke of 8, a moment of silence in memory of the Queen, as millions across Britain paused to reflect on the life of the only monarch most had ever known up until her death. At Buckingham Palace, King Charles and Camilla, the Queen consort, hosted a state reception like no other before it. Hundreds of dignitaries from around the world, including President Biden, along with other presidents, prime ministers, emperors, kings, queens, and sultans, representing nearly 200 countries and territories, gathered to honor Elizabeth II. While mourners continued to line up for hours to see the late monarch's coffin in the ancient Westminster Hall, the last viewing will be by 6:30 in the morning on Monday, the day of her state funeral.
Yeah, I think it's such a beautiful way for it to bring some off with people around who have been coming down the city for days and days and queuing up for hours.
That's
exactly what she wanted.
Hundreds of soldiers have already taken part in funeral rehearsals in what's expected to be a regal and yet deeply personal memorial. As many as 2 million people could fill the streets of London to watch the procession, and 10,000 police officers will take part in one of the largest ever security operations Britain has ever organized. In a moving tribute to the Queen, Camilla, the Queen consort, praised the late monarch as a woman, leader, and the mother-in-law she knew.
She's got those wonderful blue eyes. But when she smiles, you know, they light up her whole face. I'll always remember that smile. You know, that smile is unforgettable.
Now, British police will have to balance the need to protect world leaders with the public's desire to mourn a much-loved monarch, as Queen Elizabeth makes her last journey from here in Westminster to her final resting place in Windsor, next to her late husband, Prince Philip. Lily.
Thank you. Nora O'Donnell is also in London, where she and Bill King will anchor coverage of tomorrow's state funeral. We spoke with Nora earlier today.
Good evening, President Biden and other world leaders attended a reception hosted by King Charles III and the Queen Elizabeth and Camilla. Now, only working royals were allowed to attend, meaning Prince Harry and his wife Meghan were not there, and they were reportedly uninvited to the event. Now, earlier we saw President Biden and the First Lady paying their respects to the Queen at Westminster Hall, where her body will lie in state for just a few more hours. I have to tell you, the mood here in London is somber, as United Kingdom and the Commonwealth prepares to say a final goodbye to its longest reigning monarch. We expect tomorrow's funeral to be full of tradition, lots of symbolism, and a ceremony that was planned by the Queen.
For a queen.
Queen Elizabeth, son.
Now to breaking news in Poland. Tonight, you know, more than 1 million people is without electricity. Fiona crashed ashore today at a tribal lake in Mike Seidel of our partners at the Weather Channel is in Brunswick.
Good evening, Amelia. The roar of the wind has finally backed off tonight, but here in Tennessee, this afternoon, we were blasted by winds of 103 miles an hour. Hurricane Fiona crashed ashore with force in Puerto Rico on Sunday. Authorities have opened shelters and closed public beaches for those people to remain indoors. Serena Hartz is weathering the storm for her home in Humacao. Historic levels of rain are triggering landslides and flooding. The entire island is without power tonight, forcing many hospitals to run off generators. Puerto Rico's grid remains fragile 5 years after Hurricane Maria. In 2017, the storm caused the largest blackout in U.S. history and caused nearly 3,000 deaths. I think we've learned a lot from the last time, said Estefani Lee. So this is why we really prepared ourselves this time and bought a power generator. Power might shut down and nobody knows when it's coming back. One man died on the French Caribbean island of Guadeloupe on Saturday. Local authorities say his house was swept away by floods as Fiona barreled through. Hurricane Fiona now heading towards the eastern part of the Dominican Republic, where hurricane warnings have been listed. Tomorrow makes that turn to New York expected, taking the risk of the weather away from the Bahamas, but by the middle of the week, Bermuda will take a direct hit on what by that time could be a Category 2 hurricane.
Devastating for all of us Puerto Ricans in the diaspora. Yeah! Thank you. Tonight, floodwaters are receding in western Alaska, revealing the damage after a historic storm. CBS's Donovan Vigliotti is tracking that and other weather extremes this weekend.
In Alaska, the governor has declared a state of disaster after the remnants of Typhoon Mirba caused unprecedented flooding. From Utah to Nome, entire towns were completely submerged, with roads destroyed and homes ripped off their foundation. We're trying to assess exactly what has occurred. Again, this is almost 1,000 miles worth of storm front. Heavy rain has also moved into drought-stricken northern California. This storm, though, expected to bring relief to rural
firefighters.
The mosquito fire has burned out of control for weeks. It's California's largest wildfire. Much of the region has seen only trace amounts of rain since January. State officials are hoping the storm, now moving through, can help bring containment. In Southern California, a reminder of just how dry and vulnerable these hillsides are to fire. Flames shot up near the Hollywood Bowl in Los Angeles last night, just after a concert. It caused anxiety, but little damage. And in Florida, wild weather forced Lady Gaga to call off her show after unpredictable lightning moved over the performance arena. And back here in California, the Sacramento area is bracing for up to 2 inches of rain over the next few days. That is more rain than that region has received over the past 9 months combined, Lilia.
Climate and distress from climate change. Jonathan Vigliotti, thank you. Fighting in Ukraine this weekend has put new pressure on Russian forces, and their retreat in some areas is now revealing even worse atrocities. CBS's Deborah Kai is there.
More than 400 crosses mark shallow graves in this pine forest near Idlib. Volodymyr Kolesnik is looking for three of his relatives. He's being told their bodies are here. Number 174 is his aunt, Natalia Yakubenko. He carries on his search. Investigators will be exhuming the bodies for at least a week. Each death investigated as a possible war crime. I've never seen anything like this, Kharkiv's chief war crimes prosecutor, Oleksandr Ilyenkov, told us. The scale of killing is unbelievable. Multiple torture chambers across the region dispense the terror that kept civilian populations under control. Anatoly Kharkiv was in one of them, where he survived electric shocks and beatings.
Мы не хотели, чтобы я проснул.
They wanted me to praise Vladimir Putin on YouTube. I refused. And they told me, get ready, we're going to shoot you. These grim discoveries come after a lightning counter-offensive reclaimed most of the territory seized by Russia in the northeast in just 6 days.
It began here in Bayrut, where Russian soldiers cleared their bases like bees in panic, clearing the way for Ukrainian troops to reshape the battlefield of our truth.
Vladimir Putin's war is not going according to plan. And he's been reduced to this. The leader of the Russian mercenary group Wagner seen recruiting prisoners to fight on the front line. Wagner has been accused of human rights atrocities in Syria and Africa, raising the haunting fear of more nameless wooden crosses in a country that's already endured unimaginable suffering. Dima Pada, CBS News, Bayrut, Ukraine.
Truly atrocious. Straight ahead on the CBS Weekend News, King Charles is tested by a leaky fountain pen in his new royal rule. And lost in Pearl Harbor, a sailor is finally laid to rest.
Copperfin Energy Socks, the world's first easy on, easy off graduated compression sock. Just got better. Now, with Arch Support technology for better arch and ankle support and all the relief right where you need it.
I'm so excited about these socks.
They look fantastic. The more I want them, the better we got.
You're sitting there all day long. You lose circulation in your leg. When I put the compression socks on, I've never felt anything like it before.
And advanced stretch fabric blend for an easy on, easy off fit combined with our graduated compression fabric to help reduce swelling, relieve tired, achy muscles, and provide energizing support.
No more swelling, no more achy, tired feet.
I'm wearing socks right now. I've been in this gear all day long. They totally take it mine.
Our most advanced graduated compression fabric woven into our easy on, easy off sock to help reduce swelling discomfort from prolonged sitting or standing.
I wear them every day. My legs are not swollen. That's the whole point of wearing them.
If you have to wear a compression sock for whatever reason, these are a game changer.
A soft cushion footbed to help reduce impact discomfort, combined with our new arch support technology for targeted compression to help ease arch and ankle fatigue.
It's very exciting to wear something and then see that it really made a difference. I don't understand why all that is like this.
The most comfortable, energizing compression sock you will ever wear. Guaranteed, or your money back. Get your Copperfin Energy Socks with new arch support technology now online at getenergysocks.com for only $19.99. The total is 974-0348. Order right now, and we'll include a second pair of compression socks free. As for the original pioneer, Copperfin Energy Socks.
The British monarchy is destined to new royal roles since the death of Queen Elizabeth, after the longest reign in its history. Here's CBS's Holly Williams. When the Queen died last week, her son Charles, age 73, got the job he's been waiting for his whole life. The last person to hold the Princess of Wales title was Diana. Too tall.
Mi mamá. Mi mamá murió hace 2 meses. Siempre veo esas fotos y videos como una forma de mantener la vida. Por favor.
No parte el corazón del collero. Por favor, tranquilízate.
Bueno, pues.
¿Un burrito?
Déjame la letra. Por favor, te lo pido. Que me olviden el celular. Te lo explico. Entra el corazón de que tiene mi celular. Es mi camarero de rosa. Porque ahí está mi mayor tesoro. Los pocos minutos de mi mamita. Por favor.
Queremos hacer una oferta
en efectivo. Cuando las ofertas de tenis comienzan en $5.99, las vas a esperar en todos lados. El mundo ha de pagar 10 millones. Y es la misma esas cortillas de
¿qué está comentando, Ricardo? ¿Qué está vomitando? ¿Qué está vomitando, jefa?
Nada mal, Ana. Laura se quedó en el mismo hotel con la misma experiencia y pagó muchísimo menos. ¿Cómo lo hizo? Bueno, Ana encontró el hotel en su página de costumbre, mientras que Laura...
¿Qué es?
Según me dicen que no usará Trivago la próxima vez. ¿Hotel?
Okay. tendrían todo lo que hablo con ellos. Te contaría lo que siento por ti y por mí. Habla con las estrellas, con el sol y la luz. Habla con ellos. Y así escribí este poema de amor para ella. Pero no es el poema de amor.
Boy, I don't have enough, bro. Man, I don't have... Oh, my jeez, bro.
Esta vez será para ti, porque pase lo que pase, no eres tú.
Debe ser siempre el primero, ¿no? Y también debe ser el primero, el más serio de todos los niños. Ayuda a los niños, donde absolutamente todos los niños están en una sala que no está en la sala, porque mi mamá es, mi novia eres tú.
¿Cómo es?